Well, The Blazing World is essentially the story of a woman named Harriet Burden, who's a visual artist and has been mostly ignored. Her work has been mostly overlooked by the art world. And she decides, late in her middle age, to begin an experiment. And she uses three actual men. She calls them her pseudonyms or her masks, to show her work for her. She thinks of it as an experiment in perception. The entire book actually is a kind of experiment in perception because there are 20 narrators. Each one has a different point of view. Some return, others vanish. So the form of the book mirrors the story. People have told me, and I think it's fairly obvious, that there's a link through the art world to what I loved. At the same time, what I loved is narrated by a single narrator. There are, of course, other voices and other characters in the novel. But this is formally very different and is, in a way, intended to present multiple points of view that do not necessarily agree with one another at all. So it is a very different book in terms of how it's made, and I think probably the effect on the reader. I have drawn my whole life. I continue to draw, and I've often thought about including drawings in another book. This book, however, has artworks in it, and I wanted the reader to imagine the artworks that are described. So for me, images or drawings have another function inside a text, actual images. Here, I wanted the reader simply to imagine these artworks that appear, especially the three artworks that are part of Harriet's project called Maskings. The Blazing World is taken from a 17th century natural philosopher named Margaret Cavendish. She wrote natural philosophy. She also wrote poetry, plays, and a utopian fantasy called The Blazing World. Cavendish is a heroine of my heroine, and almost like an alter ego. She, too, was ignored by many people when she was alive. She was the Duchess of Newcastle, so a very prominent person. But her work was not taken seriously by many. 300 years later, however, Margaret Cavendish's philosophy has found its place in 17th century literature, but also her ideas turn out to be quite important and prescient for ideas about the mind and body that are being argued today.